Trees that grow fast, live long lives and reproduce slowly account for the bulk of the biomass and carbon storage in some tropical rainforests, a team of scientists says. The finding that these trees, called long-lived pioneers, play a much larger role in carbon storage than previously thought may have implications in efforts to preserve forests as a strategy to fight climate change. Unclear the extent to which tropical rainforests can help soak up excess carbon dioxide in the atmosphere produced by burning fossil fuels. Nonetheless, the new study provides insights about the role of different species of trees in carbon storage. 30 years worth of data collected from a tropical rainforest in Panama, the team has uncovered some key traits of trees that, when integrated into computer models related to climate change, will improve the model's accuracy. Earth system models used to forecast global climate decades from now, including those used by the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change. It is not possible to directly verify the forecasts of a forest model in future decades. So the researchers did the next best thing, they seeded their model with forest composition data collected at their site in Panama during the 1980s and then ran the model forward to show that it accurately represents the changes that occurred from then until now. This is called hindcasting. Next, they plan to explore how a warming world might benefit trees with certain traits over others, shifting forest composition and the potential of forests to store carbon. Using 34 years of real-world data collected from a tropical rainforest in Panama, the research team condensed 282 plant species into 5 key categories that can be fed into a computer model to create more accurate forecasts for forest development. The 5 plant types were identified as fast, slow, infertile giants, fertile dwarfs and an intermediate group. The fast plants grow and die quickly. The slow species grow sluggishly and live long. Infertile giants, or long-lived pioneers, grow quickly and live long but reproduce less. Fertile dwarfs, or short-lived breeders, grow and survive poorly but produce a lot of offspring. The intermediate group includes plants that grow at a mild pace and reproduce moderately. An international team of marine biologists showed that even slightly higher CO2 concentrations than those existing today may cause profound changes in marine habitats and the fish that rely on them. Shift from complex reefs to habitats dominated by opportunistic low-profile algae led to a 45% decrease of fish diversity.